They have to go to Russia and say, hey, let's make new friends. What choice do they have, right? But I'm telling you, Israelis are walking their dogs because their government lets them, and they're Muslims, and they're Armenians.
That's Jewish voice for peace out there.
You can't speak like that. You can't speak like that. You
wait, it's fucking Jewish voice for peace.
Yo,
this is nothing against Jewish people.
No, babe, you put it.
Don't put your finger like this.
Okay.
You know their pain. They have pain. You have pain. Enough with being a victim to pain. This is why they're so unhappy.
She's trying to interview.
What is your take on this?
I think that violence against students, no matter what.
So first of all, I want to ask you to tell me a little bit about the organization Standing Together, the background, and how you were formed.
Yeah, so Standing Together LA is a chapter of Standing Together, which is an organization that brings Israeli Jews and Palestinian citizens of Israel together to work for a better future, which, you know, involves the freedom, justice, and equality for all, you know, Israelis and Palestinians between the Jordan River and the Mediterranean Sea. And so we formed, you know, at some point that I'm forgetting, during the start of this war, as to support that crucial movement and to show, I think, American audiences are also in need of that messaging, albeit in a different fashion. So we formed in Los Angeles, and we've had activities around the city, a lot of which have taken place at UCLA.
And you're also a student here at UCLA?
Yeah.
So you've been here the last few days, I think. I know on Sunday I filmed one of the Zionists chasing you through the crowd, and he was very angry, screaming obscenities at you. You know, I think a lot of Americans don't realize that the Jewish community isn't monolithic on this particular issue, and there's a variance degrees, and that fights happen. So talk to me a little bit about the various viewpoints and what you would want Americans to hear about how Jews feel across the board, not just one faction.
Right. I mean, you know, there's Jews who identify as Zionist, there's Jews who identify as anti-Zionist, there's Jews who identify as non-Zionist. And so I think that, you know, whether, you know, I have my own politics, some people have their own interpretations of what Zionism means or doesn't mean, or what the State of Israel means or doesn't mean. But like, ultimately, every Jewish American deserves protection as Jews. And so when we have conversations about Jewish safety, we need, especially on college campuses, we need to be including the diversity of the Jewish population and not just considering only, you know, right-wing pro-Israel Jewish students, but, you know, also students in JBP. And even though I may have personal disagreements with students in that organization, they deserve just as much protection from anti-Semitism, and they deserve to be included just as much in the conversation about Jewish safety as I do. So that, to me, is really important.
Yeah, 100%. And then also another part of that conversation is that a lot of the Zionists that were here on Sunday weren't Jewish at all. They were simply Zionists. And some of them, in my opinion, were saying anti-Semitic things, but that doesn't seem to be ever addressed by anybody. So what are your thoughts on that?
I mean, just as, you know, anti-Zionism and anti-Semitism are not one and the same, I think being a Zionist and supporting the State of Israel does not absolve oneself of being anti-Semitic. I mean, we've seen this with Donald Trump, right? He is a great supporter of the State of Israel, or so he says, and, you know, has actually used his support of the State of Israel to be anti-Semitic towards the Jewish people, calling, you know, Jewish Democrats, you know, disloyal to their people. And, you know, he met with Nick Fuentes. And so I think just as it's, you know, possible to be an anti-Zionist and not be anti-Semitic, it's also possible to be a Zionist and be anti-Semitic. Although sometimes, you know, there is definitely a nexus point between the way in which Israel is discussed and, you know, the ways in which, you know, anti-Semitism occurs, but, you know, conflating people's positions on Zionism with their position on Jews and American Jewry as a whole, I think, is false.
Yeah. That makes sense. So Standing Together, what are the things that you're looking to do? Some of your signs are talking about a ceasefire, full hostage deal. So clearly these are things that everybody should support.
Yeah.
You know, one of the things that I heard on Sunday from some of the Zionists was they were in denial about the fact that the IDF has killed some of the hostages with their indiscriminate bombing. I'm not saying that was an intentional thing that they did, but maybe an unintended consequence of that choice. How does that all fit into where you guys stand?
Yeah, there's a lot of denialism right now. I think there are people who deny the atrocities on October 7th. There's people who deny not only that hostages were killed, but people who deny famine in Gaza or the level of carnage in Gaza. And so denialism, I think, is a huge problem. And there's a ton of misinformation and disinformation on social media right now. And standing together is not our main, you know, obviously we think education is important, but we're, at the end of the day, we're an advocacy group. We have a particular political position, and we try to provide people with resources and education. And, you know, it's important to us and our values to be accurate and precise. But of course, you know, news is constantly changing. And so, you know, just trying to shout people out of denialism is not an effective solution in whatever form that denialism takes.
Indeed. So what are some parting thoughts that you would want to share with folks that you think that is missing from the conversation?
I think just, you know, supporting, I think that, like, sorry, I'm just trying
to. That's okay.
Everyone's in a lot of pain right now, and the violence yesterday was completely and utterly unacceptable and abhorrent. The people who are doing it are in a lot of pain, and they are expressing it in a terrible way. And I think that's something we've seen throughout this conflict in many different ways. And so I think when we lead with compassion, as hard as it is, it's so much easier said than done, but trying to lead with compassion rather than anger and a recognition that we are profoundly hurting right now, I think is a better way to approach human beings.
We met at the dialogue.